Okay, so look at the phrase, I am that I am. And then, I mean, I know people do this. If you've ever heard someone shorten it to just the I am, I don't know if they're supposed to do that. Like, because it's presupposes your conceptuality of what is normal and the way things are, how things exist. But when said fully, like when you say, I am that I am, then it's just a consideration. So, because I mean, I can understand that that could be a tribute to the words of Christ, right? The living, right? Because it's timelessness. It's like, I am that I am, in a timeless consideration that people, you're not wrong. Like, I don't wanna say that, you know, but it's kind of like you're special. Special slow boys on this special yellow bus. Because you say like I am or something, like it's like you're taking away something of meaning. And you did take away something of meaning. Okay, but I could be doing something counterproductive too, which is like making commentary about the modalist humanist, as somebody explained that they, because this is how you, it's a lot of words, all right? They're modalist, humanist, Unitarian, Fabian. What's it called? Okay, the noble life thing. You know, it's like magical thinking. Okay, here's a word, right? Magic is everything and nothing. It's everywhere and nowhere, and it'll aid you. We put it in a lot of things, like, you know, fancy cartoons like Pixar or whatever. Like, it's like magic, like, you know, like fun. It's like all, you know, like all good. It's still a word for a problem of something we don't understand, and maybe a process of crystallization that you don't understand or never seen before demonstrated, or it could be like you, these are just the different ways that we use a word, not saying what it is, because if it's a problem for something we don't know and we use it in a system, then magical systems don't work. And then when something does work, like Tao, a Tao, we call it a magical system because it works, like giving the wrong attribute. Magical thinking is something referred to as like stinking thinking. You know, like it's not physical. You could see it with your mind's eye. You can see, it's like thinking, you can see it with your mind's eye and it's stinking. That's not, I mean, the same thing, obviously. I kept to reiterate that these are just words, but it's the same word, right? It's like the same word, just how we use it. So it's not, you know, I keep saying it. I gotta stop saying it, because something is presupposition of conceptualization of norm of of the way things are, of the way the nature of being and the way things are in existence, has to do with perspective that you come by sometimes with a, you have to wade through and filter, wade, and look for what's, you have to filter out what's not for you. When once you find out what's for you, you don't have to filter, but that's not what anybody's going to tell you, obviously. Oh shit. But about the subject of the word magic, because you can't open up about the subject of magic, you know, everywhere and nowhere, you know what I mean? Like, a little bit, you get like less than a tiny grain of sand. It gets pulled in to the atmosphere by the poles. They suck coldness from space. It's not because they're distant from the sun. It's because the magnetic polar caps are like rods that are geothermal. Like, it's like you can convert cold energy into heat and shit like that. So the sun is a monochrome orb. It's neither bright nor warm. It can reflect the radiation of the soul that you can reflect. You can detect in the physical. That is in the physical domain is heat and light. The sun is codifying everything. The sun is codifying inner space, the time, what the concept of time. It's what time is in on the sun, right? If you look at the sun in the physical domain, right, this has like, you know, fiery temper, you know. Of course it is that. Who's gonna argue it's not? But the world is a symbol around you. Some things that resonate that are proven to be true maybe a million times. It's like you see reverberating through everything else. So it's like the tree, the root, the bark, the leaf, it's all the same substance. Your ears look like embryonic state. Like your ears are the reproductive organ of the spirit, and looks like an embryo, and yeah, it's like on both sides of your head. It's weird, like that, like how there's some things going on with energies that are constellations that are provided, that they explain things, processes and things going on the earth, entropy and putrefaction, and maybe there's even a natural occurring nuclear power plant in I forget where it's called in Africa, but this water keeps going down and cooling the core, and it allows for this nuclear chain, this nuclear reaction process, and there's a whole process of rendering the depleted uranium back into inertia or some shit like. But it just, so it's like all the technology is all primordial. It's all primordial. You're just not, you don't have, what's it called, advanced knowledge of it, and a way to wield it as means or something like that. They have to get you to need it. Sometimes maybe you don't even need it. I'm just gonna have to connect this ramble with like two other rambles to see where I'm headed with this, because I that's probably a better way than that's probably a better way than, you know, using systems or something.